Today we're going to talk about the null modem and connecting with an indicator. So basically, if we have to wire up a connector, it sometimes is handy to have what's called a null modem adapter. They come in different shapes and different sizes. Here's a female to female adapter on both sides. It's a 9-pin, and then we have a 9-pin to the male side on another null modem. These would be put into line if we were unsure with our USB to serial adapter going to our channel 1 or serial port 1 on a 1280. We have connected it correctly here, so we have our ground, transmit, and receive going to our ground, receive, and transmit. In between is just another gender changer, so there are varying different ones. And once we connect that, it is sometimes beneficial. We can use Revolution, Procom, Putty. I've just used Revolution. I'm gonna turn that a little bit. And if I connect, you're gonna see it's initiating connection, checking for Bluetooth. And then we're connected to the indicator. That's pretty easy. So if I disconnect, remove my my cable, I'll switch my wires around so that it could be backwards.
I mean, that's something that if it got changed, that could release the...
Now, if that was backwards and I tried to connect, it'll go through the checking and connecting, and it'll tell us that we have a device type mismatch. So if I close, I'll have to remove my connector, add a gender changer to my serial port here, and then my null modem adapter. So I put my null modem on, which is gonna automatically switch my wires for me, and then I try to connect again. And then I'm connected to the indicator. So what we can have here is if I put my cable on, I knew it was backwards. Instead of rewiring, I could just throw my null modem adapter on and automatically have it connect.